Welcome inside the rink here with Tangs and Lots. And Tangs, you were just telling us that your kids have been watching this recurring theme in the car recently. We've been seeing it the last couple of nights on NHL Tonight, and it worked so well for Kenan Thompson back in the day. The Americans get him to that championship game against Iceland in Mighty Ducks 2. The Knuckle Puck.
The Knuckle Puck. It was a classic in Mighty Ducks 2. But you see it still in the National Hockey League more often than not. We're watching the game the other night. Of course, we're watching the Penguins and the Capitals. It's a thrilling game. It's up and down. There's an innocent-looking turnover in the neutral zone. Matt Niskanen's going to chip it up to Jakub Vrana, who chips it to TJ Oshie. Oshie back to Vrana, to Backstrom, back to Vrana, and Verana's going to end up with it outside the dot. Not necessarily a prime scoring area, but it doesn't matter if you catch a puck on its edge. Exactly how Jakub Vrana does. Look at the flex he gets on his stick. If we could zoom in even more, we'll show it to you even better. But that puck is laying perfectly flat. So how does it look? It looks exactly like this right here. He's got it right on his blade, and the puck is standing up. The classic knuckle puck from Mighty Ducks 2. All he's going to do from here, though, is go into his normal shot routine and sling it rather than roll the wrist up. He's just going to kind of turn the wrist over and sling it. It looks like this, right in the top corner. Alex, show us how you can feel that puck.
Well,
blade.
You just feel the puck. And
you've got great hands.
And, you know, let's see if we can, I mean, you can sling it. Baby. Those kids, they can, you know, throw it.
Yeah.
But the middies are still going. But, you know, as Brian just mentioned, you know, it's like, when we watch baseball, Tim Wakefield was pitching. The catcher came out with a bigger glove because unlike a knuckleball, a shot being shot that way sideways, it catch air. So it starts floating. So you don't know where it's going. So as much for the shooters, where Vrana is that instance, he's just trying to hit the net because he knows it's floating and it's going to move. The netminder, like Matt Murray in that instance, it's like waving to the bench, like, hey, bring me the bigger glove. I don't know where this one is going. And that's truly a shot that's so hard to defend.
Yeah. Let's just show another one that we saw there the other night.
Sure.
You see it? Marc-Andre Vlasic shooting it from that side. Alex, go ahead, take a shot there. We'll do this one really quick. Same thing. It's a knuckle puck. You got a forward in front. Alex is going to be Marc Eduardo Vlasic. All he's going to do is slap at this one, and this one's hard to control. I don't have a helmet here, but that's okay if you hit me in the head, Alex. I can take it. Take a look right there as you see Barclay Goodrow eventually gets in the way of the netminder, and all he's going to do is let this glance off his body into the net. But it's the play by Vlasic that recognizes he's got a little bit of a puck standing on edge. He lays into it. Go ahead and take a couple of those,
yeah,
Alex.
See because if you've got that shot, like, I'm just taking the shot. I'm going towards Lodz because I know he's come to the net. So if it hits him, most likely it's going in. So I'm taking this one, hits the stick, and it goes in. You know, in that instance, you know, Barclay Goodrow was driving. It hit his chest or hit his stomach and went into the net. But they don't ask how. They ask how many.
Right.
And certainly it's been the case. I mean, anytime you've got that puck on edge like this, as Lodz just showed, you know, he's aiming at the middle of the net because he doesn't know which way it's going to float. And that, for the netminder, is so hard to defense, you know. And in the building that we play in, with the amount of, you know, the skating that's going on, the puck is frozen. I mean, it's going to be moving. So you're not always going to have a flat putt where you can lay it flat. It's going to be bouncing. There's going to be movement. And those guys are such professional. We've worked on those shots all our life. We know what the feel is. Once that puck is on your stick, like right here, I would feel it. I don't even have to look at the puck. I know that that puck is flat on my stick. So at that point, you know, you've got to realize that, hey, middle of the net, it's going to float. It's going to give me a chance.
As a shooter, are you kind of programmed to, hey, if it feels like that, if it's on edge, just put it on net? Maybe not try to make the pretty play, just throw it on net?
Aim for the center of the net and just let it go as quick as you can. These are shots that we did practice as professionals. Kids at home, you should be practicing them. Fans at home, watch out for these types of shots because a lot of times the goalie will look way off and you'll be like, my goodness, what happened there on such and such by such and such
on
goalie?
Replay, you see
all it is they're trying to deal with essentially a giant sinker, a curveball, a knuckle puck, whatever you want to call it.
A knuckleball.